the reason why I don't recommend adding kitchen and bathroom wastewater to biodigester and its soak away. In other words, why you have to do a separate soak away for your kitchen and bathroom wastewater. This is Dreamhouse Biodigesters. If you are new to this channel, consider subscribing for videos that explains how biodigesters are working and how they are helping homeowners have a new lease of life. My newly designed biodigester, how to construct a biodigester course, is up and running live. Link is in the description box below. Whenever I'm agreeing to terms for a new biodigester construction for a prospective client, what I do tell them is that we are not going to add the kitchen and bathroom wastewater to the biodigester one. Instead, a separate soakaway must be constructed for those two. And either they do understand it, or some of them are quick to disagree, saying that they do not want plenty soakaways in their compound. What I also do recommend, and I tell them, is that that is the best and safer option for you. After some of them exclaim that the price will then go up and it does not make sense to construct a biodigester and have a separate soakaway for their kitchen and bathhouse. The truth is, even when you do consider construction of a septic tank as your waste management option, you are still not going to add the kitchen and bathhouse wastewater to the septic tank. You will be required to add the kitchen wastewater to the soakaway that will be attached to the septic tank. I have a clear and concrete proof why you must not add a kitchen soakaway or kitchen and bathroom wastewater to the biodigester. In this video, that's exactly what I'm going to explain to you, so stick with me. I once did a biodigester for a family who had a 4-bedroom house. That's a standard family size property. And after 2 months of using the biodigester, I had a call that said that there's a lot of water in their backyard and that they're angry, they are disappointed in constructing a biodigester because it seems the digester is ineffective in managing their toilet wastewater. I quickly sent a team over to their place. After an inspection was done, we realized that the kitchen and the bathroom wastewater has been or was added to the biodigester and it's soaked away. After inquiring from the family, they told me that when the plumber came to do the connection, he then decided to add both the kitchen and the bathroom wastewater to the digester. So there's a reason why the water was overflowing. I had to explain to the couple or the family that if you do add this, there's a reason why I do not recommend that, and that's exactly what we are going to talk about. After a few checks and conversation and an understanding and inquiries, we all came to the conclusion that the couple's 5-year-old girl was in the washroom, that's the bathroom, and then had inadvertently opened the tap and left it open. So the water had flown from the bathhouse all the way into the digester through the soakaway, and it has overflown this and filling the whole house, making the whole place wet. When you construct a biodigester, one of the first key things that I always tell you, or I will always say, is to do a separate soakaway for your kitchen and bathhouse. There's a reason for that. Kitchen and bathroom wastewater is not regulated. So it means that wastewater from the toilet room, that's the water closet unit or the full flush unit, are regulated. Whenever you visit the washroom, that's the toilet or the loo, and then you finish what you are supposed to do and you flush the unit, you cannot flush immediately again. What it means is that after the flushing of the unit, it will take time for the water to fill the tank again before it can be flushed. So let's say you have a kid who goes to the washroom and then decides to stay there and just play or play with the flush unit. He or she is not going to be able to keep on flashing the unit over and over and over again, because after one flash you are going to wait 2 or 3 minutes for the water to fill up again before you can flash. Hopefully in that moment you will be able to find out what's going on and then you can put your kid to order. But in the case of a bathtub or a sink or a kitchen sink, you cannot regulate it, because if somebody goes there and inadvertently or mistakenly leaves the tap open or the bathtub open, the water is not regulated, so all those water will just flow into the soakaway, and that will render the soakaway ineffective. That's why we say kitchen and bathroom waters are not regulated. If mommy is washing the bowls or the dishes in the kitchen and mistakenly leaves the tap open, the whole place the water will flow all the way to the soakaway. Let's say you've added it to the digester, it will flow all the way through the digester into the digester soakaway and render the digester itself ineffective. Remember, when we say we do biodigesters, the most effective way or the reason why biodigesters work is because we separate the water from the human waste. So by adding the kitchen or the bathroom wastewater to it, you are virtually rendering the digester from working to its full capacity. That's why we always recommend a separate soakaway for your kitchen and bathroom water, because those waters are not regulated and can be mistakenly left on, and then it will overflow the sink or the tank and then cause a whole lot of problem in your backyard. Most people will always recommend you putting those water in the gutter or doing your overflow tank that connects the pipes into the gutter, so that there is a continuous flow of the water. So if there's a mistake by anybody in the house, or the kitchen tap is left on, or the bathroom tap is left on, or the bathroom sink is left on after somebody brushing their teeth or washing their hands, then those water will just go into the soakaway, get to its overflow level, and then will seep into wherever it's supposed to go. But if you do construct a biodigester, you know you are in safe hands, because in the morning when you wake up after visiting the toilet and you flush, it will take time for the water to fill the tank again before it can be flushed. So then that gives room for the biodigester itself to separate the water from the human waste, for that water to go into the soakaway and still wait for the subsequent one that will come. So if there's 4 or 5 family people living in the house and we are all going to use the toilet, each system will take its own time for the flush unit to get to the digester and then pass through the system, and in the process giving the digester a breathing room to work well. So my recommendation to those who are interested in the construction of a biodigester is that a separate soakaway must be done for your kitchen and then your bathroom wastewater. In that process, in that way, you are going to have the needed peace of mind that you need in terms of your toilet wastewater management. And for biodigester constructors, insist on having a separate soakaway done for the kitchen and wastewater. Sometimes the customers or the prospective clients might complain that their cost will go up, but it's better to have a safer option than to go back and do a digester and then the wastewater from the kitchen and bathhouse in the process rendering the digester ineffective, and then people will complain and say the biodigesters do not work. Separate your kitchen wastewater from your digester soakaway. The next video showing up on your screen will explain in further details why biodigesters are your best bet when it comes to your toilet wastewater management. Click on it and watch it, and then you'll be glad you did.